Hello and welcome back to the channel. Today I want to talk about something that surprisingly I seem to be the only trans woman I've encountered that is actually doing. And this relates to my own hormone replacement therapy. A little disclaimer first, this is all about my own personal experiences. This is not medical advice. I'm not an endocrinologist. I have just been working with endocrinologists over the past 13 years to give myself female hormone replacement therapy. And it's been a long journey. In another video, I will go into my relationship and different aspects I've had of communication, different programs I've gone through with different doctors relating to my HRT. But this specifically is focusing on cycling of hormones. When I first went to my endocrinologist for the very first time to start HRT, I asked about testing of hormones, and that particular doctor did not do any testing of hormones because he said the quantities of hormones, especially in women, change so radically throughout the day. And he had actually also wanted me to go on depot-style injectables, which I did not want to do because they are modified from the natural hormone that women have. So I wound up going with the pills. Thankfully, I had just wound up, out of sheer happenstance, running across a magazine article with Suzanne Summers talking about HRT and going into that, all those details extensively. Now, unfortunately, I've never been able to do more than estradiol and progesterone. I haven't been able to take the other forms of estrogen. But overall, this has worked out fairly well for me. But when I first started taking HRT, I wasn't seeing a whole lot of effect, and I was taking progesterone, particularly for breast development. I didn't see a whole lot of work with it, though, and then I started researching what the menstrual cycle was like, and then going through and realizing that in a natural menstrual cycle, they are not consistent. The hormones aren't just, you know, the same every day as I was prescribed. So I developed a basic cycle of hormones that you're seeing on the screen here. This is just when I started out, I was doing a 28-day cycle because that is, let's consider the average menstrual cycle. Of course, having known from many women over the years, that's not the case. Menstrual cycles are not always the same length, and they vary quite a bit. I have adjusted that over time. The more I learned about the menstrual cycle, the more I learned that it has, you know, traditionally been tied with the moon, especially before industrialized times when we had lots of light that was artificial during the evening. So, I have adjusted it to be more like the actual moon cycle. The moon cycle is a 29.4-day cycle. I've adjusted it to be, I've put one up here that's 29 days, and that's what I'm using currently. Before I had orchiectomy, I was, you know, not taking any testosterone. And after orchiectomy, I wasn't for quite a while, too. About 2 years, I was without any extra testosterone, and it caused a lot of problems for me. And I feel like this is a really common issue with trans women, because trans women are so terrorized by testosterone that they never want to take any more of it again. But the thing is, I had, after my orchiectomy, I had barely a tenth to a fifth of what a natal woman would have. Well, not natal, I shouldn't say that, but what a woman born with all the right parts, let's say, has, with ovaries and etc. So, through the advice of my doctor and therapist at the time, I started taking a testosterone supplement and also increased the amount of estrogen I was taking. And that actually made a huge difference in my life. I can't even express how big a difference that made. I no longer was tired all the time. I felt like I could actually use my muscles again. I could just kind of live a more normal life again. And then eventually, as part of that, we increased the progesterone slightly, along with the increase in estrogen to balance it out, and it's working really well. My breast development has made huge leaps and bounds over the past 12 plus years that I've been doing this. And I've gone from what I believe was a 36 or a 38A to now being a 46 double D in bra size. So I'm very happy with that. And also just your body, it feels better for your body. Your body needs the rest from hormones once a month. And it's ready for more hormones again once a month. It's easy for doctors to just say, here, take this with the same dosage every day. But I don't feel like enough thought has been given into what that actually means for how bodies are. Why I seem to be the only one doing a menstrual cycle for my hormone HRT is kind of baffling to me. But again, this is just my own personal experience. This is not medical advice. Please consult your own doctor and endocrinologist and find out what works best for you. But to me, grounding yourself in the way our bodies actually evolved to take female hormones or to process female hormones is really, really helpful, I find. If you have comments, questions, please leave them below, and I'd be happy to discuss this more with you. I have a feeling there may be a follow-up video for this, definitely one for talking about endocrinology some more, because it's such an interesting topic and there's so much to it. I feel like I've become an amateur endocrinologist just to try and manage my own hormones. Not that I am, but you know, I wish I could manage to make it to medical school, and then I could be a pediatric endocrinologist and help out lots of other people. Maybe someday. So I hope this has been helpful to you. May you be well. May you be blessed. May you find infinite peace. May you be perfectly healed. May you be perfectly healthy. May you be perfectly enlightened. Aloha.